So how can we now find out the actual frequency response? Yeah, so what is the actual frequency response? Frequency response of our FIR filter. Remember, we had our ideal frequency response, so this was our ideal response. So here we've got our omega, and this was here H. This was the ideal response. But from there we did a inverse Fourier transform. Did the inverse Fourier transform. We sampled the impulse response. We windowed it. And maybe even quantized it, and so on and so on. So therefore the impulse response here, impulse response, which we are getting out here, so it must look different to the original desired frequency response. So in order to find our real frequency response now, or the real or actual frequency response, can just obviously do just a Fourier transform again. In this case, because we are sampled, so we're using a DFT or obviously an FFT. So let's do that. So let's create a real frequency response. So in this case, we just plot the absolute value of the FFT of our impulse response here. So now we see here, that's our frequency response here. So we see the actual signal, the actual response here, and then here the mirror. So let's just zoom in here a bit into that. So we see here that this response sits right at the exact amount where we would like to have it here for our 400 samples. So at if we are subtracting our MATLAB problem, then we are exactly at 20 here. So what we see here, we've got these quite nasty ripples here on the side, and the damping is not that great as we are expecting this to be. So now we could also plot this frequency response in decibel, because this gives us a better understanding of the filter. People usually would like to see this in logarithmic units. So frequency response in decibel. And the frequency response in decibel would be usually plotted as 20 log to the base of 10, and then V out divided by V in. Yeah, so in this case here it would be 20 log and then the absolute value of the H2J omega for the different frequencies here, and again to 10. Okay, so let's do that. So the only thing what we need to do is here 20 times log 10. Do that. So and so now we got this plot out here in decibel. This gives us a better understanding how this works. So we see again the ripples here, so they are not much squashed, and we see so we're getting an overall damping of -20 for the 50 hertz here.